بسم الله، الحمد لله، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. أبو بردة رضي الله عنه who is the son of أبو موسى الأشعري رضي الله عنه، صحب أبو بردة في سفر مع زيد بن أبي كبشة أو يزيد بن أبي كبشة رضي الله عنه، وكان يزيد يصوم في السفر، فقال له: سمعت أبا موسى الأشعري رضي الله عنه مرارا يقول: قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: إذا مرض العبد أو سافر كتب له من العمل ما كان يعمل مقيما صحيحا. This hadith is relating to the blessing and the great bounty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on us in rewarding us for the actions that we do. This tabi'i, the son of Abu Musa al-Ash'ari radiallahu anhu, he was accompanying another companion, and he used to fast. This companion used to fast in the travel or during the travel. So he told him, I heard Abu Musa al-Ash'ari, which is his dad, I heard him many times saying that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if the servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala becomes sick or he travels, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward for him what he used to do when he was residing and when he was healthy. This hadith is unbelievable for those people who want to get the hasanat at times that they cannot get it or very difficult to get it. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's messenger told us about being steadfast or doing good. أَحَبُّ الْأَعْمَالِ إِلَى اللَّهِ أَدْوَمُهَا وَإِنْ قَلِ. The most beloved acts of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that you are steadfast on, even if it's very little. Now the advantage of being steadfast on that is you're constantly remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you donate now $1,000 versus if you donate every day $100, so you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala 10 times in 10 days rather than just one time. And that is the advantage of remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala too much. So this is one advantage. The second advantage is this hadith. If you are used to doing, like you pray duha every day, and you fast Mondays and Thursdays, and let's say you donate $20 every time you come to the masjid, and you're steadfast on that. Sometime comes that you don't have the money. It is rewarding for you that you donate $20. Sometimes you travel, and in a travel, fast, very hard and difficult, and you have no idea when Maghrib is, when Fajr is, and questions and everything. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you that fast. You get sick, and sometimes, may Allah forbid, terminal the sickness or disease, that you can hardly do anything. Everything that you used to do, and your constant on, is reported as if you're doing it, even if it is fard. Now this is generally for the nafil. But if it's fard, like you can't stand anymore, you sit on a chair, it's reported that you are standing. Or you lay down, or maybe you pray with your eyes if you cannot. All of that will be reported as if you're doing it perfectly the way you were doing it when you are healthy or when you are not traveling. So this hadith is a glad tidings of how merciful Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is, at the same time, how you should plan your life and be smart and pick few things that you can constantly do. Do it in your life, and we have no idea when we travel or when we become sick. The blessings and the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to be the reward for inshallah. Do it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect you all. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us always remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and give us